Hey guys, welcome back. So today's video is going to be on Shodan, which is a search engine for internet connected devices. Before we get started, I wanted to add a little disclaimer. Some of the techniques I'm going to be showing you today can't potentially be considered malicious and illegal. So you should always get clear, explicit permission to conduct any research using Shodan and definitely not do anything stupid. I'm demonstrating these techniques for educational purposes only, so if you end up doing something foolish, believe me, you will get caught and there will be consequences. So please be smart and only use this content to educate yourselves. Enough with the buzz killer, let's get cracking. Here you can see the official page at shodan.io. There's a search tab and down below you can see all the filters you can apply in your queries. You can view them all and get some examples to get you started. If you go up in this other tab, we have prices for different subscription plans. Today we're going to be using a free version that only requires you to register a user account, get your API keys, and in this last tab we have the super awesome ICS radar, which shows you protocols being used in industrial systems. So you can see connected ICS devices, the Shodan crawler, and honeypots. This is a really awesome feature of Shodan. So in the past video, we discussed a specific protocol used in SCADA, which is Modbus. Here I have a list of other common ports being used in industrial control systems, such as BACnet, DMP3, Niagara Fox. We can actually use ANMAP to probe some of these ports. We can run a scan with a 1 second delay against whatever target you want with this one-liner specifying the most common SCADA ports. We can go at this point back to Shodan and we can test for Modbus. So first we need to specify a port, :502. Let it run. As you can see, there are over 360,000 devices connected with this protocol worldwide. You can see a map with top countries, organizations. If you go down and scroll down, you can see products and operating systems which work on top of Modbus. Let's try another one next. We can look for BACnet, which runs on port 47. A08, and in this case we have 37,000 devices which utilize BACnet. As you can see, there's BACnet broadcast management device. Now Shodan allows you to search by geographical location. So if we input city of Foshan, which is a city in China, we let it run, and as you can see we get 206,000 odd results. Again, we can see top ports, top organizations in a specific city. Similarly, we can search for a specific country. We could try China again. Let it run for a sec. As you can see here, we have a whopping 54 million results. Again, you get top cities, top ports. Now, we can start searching for a particular vendor. We can try Schneider Electric. Oh, geez, I fucked it up. I forgot an N. Schneider with an N here. And there you go. So we get over 4,500 results. If we add, see, top countries again, if we add SAS, so Schneider SAS, to the query, we can refine the search even more. So we get 151 results in here. We can click on the top one. So you can see here, this one runs on Modbus on port 502. Now we can look into some firmware manufactured by a specific vendor. We can try Siemens Cymatic. So Cymatic is a series of logic controller and automation systems, which are developed by Siemens and run by default on port 161. We got over 1,000 results for these. We can take a look at this one in Japan. Let's click on it, check it out. So we have different ports available. We can click on TCP and we find this login form. Now, at this point, you can try and find out whether this login form can be brute forced. You could try out and see if there's a lockout policy in place or search for default creds. Let's move back and check out routers. We can try Scalence S615, which is a flagship router manufactured by Siemens. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So this one right here, that'd be it. And of course, you could look for default creds. So back to Shodan. We can further refine the search and include only results in a specific country. So we can try country, we can try Germany, which is DE. Just like that. So as you can see, we got 30 results specifically in Germany. So we can click on this one. Right. And again, there's a bunch of ports available. You got 161. We have TCP. If we click on it, you see that we're redirected to a login form. And at this point, again, we could look for default creds for this router. So if we do Scalence default password, we find a default password of admin. So chances are that this might not be it. But once you have thousands or potentially millions of targets, lots of these targets are bound to have default creds set up. So a malicious attacker might try and either brute force or just log in with default creds. So now we can do something a bit juicier and look into RDP and VNC and include entries with a screenshot. As you can see, we have 1 million results. And down here, there's a ton of information that could be used to do bad, bad things and should not be laying around like that. So we have versions and all kinds of stuff. We can go up and we could either refine the search and include other parameters. We could try and include SCADA as a parameter and see what we get. We had 48 results, which include SCADA. So it's possible that these targets are somehow part of an industrial complex. So now we can kick it up a notch and search for devices connected using VNC, which do not require authentication. So we can add this parameter here, which specifies that authentication is disabled. This RFB 003008. And look at that. We find 9,000 plus systems that are basically fish in a barrel like that. So they're just out in the open, no authentication required, and pretty much anybody could just, you know, check in. We can run a Metasploit scanner to see if they're indeed vulnerable. We run this VNC non-authentication module. Let's give it a spin. Our host, and there you have it. So you can see that this is completely vulnerable. There's no, there's free access. There's no authentication required whatsoever. So if you look at the sheer amount of devices which are connected to the internet using RDP, you'll get a heart attack, I promise you that. So if we search for 3389, which is specific for remote desktop, we get 5.7 plus million devices. And chances are that tens of thousands are either unpatched and left vulnerable like that, or they do not require any type of authentication. We can again include a SCADA parameter to find the ones that are potentially part of industrial complexes. You have in Romania, there's in Germany. Now, we can look at screenshots, which are labeled as ICS. So we can do the screenshot.label ICS. Let it run. And as expected, we have a ton of entries. We have over 1,000. Oh, look at that. So there's like flare flow rate, flare temperature. We can refine the search and add VNC as a parameter as well. Now, keep in mind that not all of these IP addresses are connected to critical infrastructure, but just in terms of absolute numbers, this is pretty scary. As you can see at the very top here, this one in Korea has authentication disabled. This one, I guess it's some type of water tank. And this stuff is pretty scary. We have this one in Korea. Again, some type of control panel. Now, we can also search by host name. So we can type a domain name we want to search for, and it's going to spit out all of the connected IP addresses. So we can try this particular one. Let it run, and in a second you'll see that you have roughly 54 results. I've searched for this one before. Let's give it a second. And in fact, you see that we have indeed 54 targets located in China and Hong Kong, the top ports, yada yada. Now, we can look into FTP accounts, which allow for anonymous login. So if we add port 21, and this 230, so this 230 here signifies that anonymous login is enabled. And as you can see here, this is an absolute disgrace. There are over 300,000 plus FTP clients just out in the wild like that. I'll show you guys just how ridiculous this is. So we can go back to our Kali monitor, and I'll blur out the IP address of these morons. So I can just connect to this host and log in without creds with anonymous login. LSLA. See this incoming. This is from 2011. So at this point, I could exfiltrate all of this data, or even worse, I could upload a malicious payload on this target and then just escalate my privileges from there. So this is definitely scary. Next, we can try and look into, let's clear out the terminal, go back here, and we can look into SMB or Samba shares, which have authentication disabled. So we can try the default port 445 and add these authentication disabled. Let it run. It's going to take a second. Wow. So look at that. We have an astonishing 600,000 shares just laying there like that. There's all kinds of stuff. Now, if you have over 500,000 shares, which do not require authentication, like, you better believe that there's going to be like some juicy stuff in there. So at this point, we could refine our parameters and look for specific keywords like healthcare or tax returns. We can try clients and see what we get. So if we had this client parameter, let's see what we got. 68. This is absolutely insane. So the amount of sensitive data that stays like unprotected like this. So we have the shares client. Now I can show you how a malicious attacker, what a malicious attacker might do in a situation like this. So we can use CrackMap Exec to log in as a guest without supplying a password. And as you can see, that works. We could also use SMB Client to probe for the shares. We can try that. So this password is my Kali Attack Box password. And there you go. So at this point, I mean, the possibilities are endless. This is pretty much child's play. You don't need a lot of technical expertise to pull this off. Now that we've seen how to use the online version of Shodan, we can look into how to use it from the command line. So let me zoom in just a second. The first thing you want to do is initialize Shodan using your private API keys. So you can type Shodan in it and then add your API keys. I've blurred out my personal API keys. And now we can use Shodan to search for a specific vendor ID. So we can try that out. So Shodan search vendor ID, we have Rockwell Automation, Allen Bradley. So they sell industrial automation components. It's a pretty big vendor. Now, a simple query like this is not going to be very manageable, as you'll see in a second. It's going to spit out a bunch of data, which is not very useful, at least in this form. So what can we do? Well, for instance, we can use the stats command together with the facets flag, which basically allows to get a distribution of values for a property, which in this case is the ports available for a particular vendor, Siemens. And here you have all those values. Next, we can use another options. For instance, let's clear it out. We can do Shodan, if I could type Shodan. And then we can do search. And then we add the fields option, which accepts a comma separated list of property names. So we can add IP string and port for a given host name. We can try any.com. And then we can redirect the output to a target.txt file. Now, once that's done, we can check how many entries we got. We got 41. And now we can parse for a specific port using grep. So just like that, we have a list of targets, and then we could continue a reconnaissance using AdMap or other tools. Now, so that would be it for today. I'm gonna say this again: some of the techniques we have tried today can potentially be considered illegal and cause great harm to both companies and individuals. So please be respectful. Avoid doing anything that you might regret. As always, I hope you guys have enjoyed the video, and let me know what you think down below in the comment section. See ya.